Right now, a 19-year-old from Verona found dead in North Carolina. What we know about the circumstances.
Plus, here comes the heat. We're going to have the warning signs that your dog could be overheated.
And we are tracking severe storms just north of Madison this morning. We'll see if we see any rain here in the Madison area coming up.
Good Wednesday morning, everyone, and welcome to News 3 Now this morning. I'm Chris Stanford.
And I'm Leah Lynch-Eyed. Happy Wednesday. We have really active weather to the north and the west. Kelly is tracking on whether we're going to see it here in Madison.
Yeah, the storms that are occurring this morning that have been possibly producing winds to 60 miles per hour are going to stay north of Madison, but Dell's already seen some of these storms roll through, now moving into northern parts of Columbia County, headed it through Green Lake and Marquette counties as well. Notice all the lightning strikes. This is the severe thunderstorm warning watch box. It does extend into a northern Columbia County and extreme northern Sauk County. That's going to stay to the north of Madison, but what we'll watch is this tail end right now moving out of Iowa, Prairie du Chien area. Some of those scattered showers and storms will likely reach the Madison area a little bit later on this morning. That's when we can expect some of these storms to roll on through. But really intense rains with the severe thunderstorm warning in effect until 6:15. Green Lake, Marquette County, northern Columbia County into northern Sauk County. See some of these deep reds indicating a heavy rain and also possibility of seeing some of these winds up to 60 miles per hour. So we're seeing some scattered showers out here toward Lone Rock and Dodgeville, but also some storms rolling in out of Iowa, Prairie du Chien area. Some of those may roll into the Madison area over the next couple of hours. That's what we can expect this morning. A lot of that will weaken. Then the clouds will depart gradually as we get in the afternoon. It's going to get very steamy after the rain we have this morning. Temperatures in the upper 80s. We'd be a lot warmer, but I think the clouds will linger a little bit into the early afternoon. 75 right now in Madison. It's a sticky start to the day after the morning storms. It's going to be hazy and humid today. The hottest day, though, coming in tomorrow. Looks like we will get some relief by the upcoming weekend. Meantime, it's going to be a hot afternoon with the storms coming to an end this morning. Afternoon sunshine, upper 80s today. More on those storms and another chance for some storms. And we do break the heat this weekend. More coming up in about 15 minutes.
Kelly, thank you very much. Hey, if you don't have air conditioning and you're in need of a place to cool down during the heat wave, there are available cooling centers around Dane County. Here's a look at some of the locations. In Middleton, Sun Prairie, Beloit, and Madison, there are more, too. Head to channel3000.com to see more locations and the times that they're open.
A little easier for us if we want to beat this extreme heat by staying indoors.
But some of our furry friends just want to be outside using up all of their energy. Shane Hogan has some cooling tips for your pets. Good morning, Shane.
Good morning, Leah. That's right. If you're going to be hot, your pet's going to be even hotter. That's what experts at the Dane County Humane Society are saying this morning. During this time of excessive heat, it's important to limit your pet's time outside. Our pets can't really tell us when they're getting overheated, but there are signs that you can look out for heat stroke to make sure that your pup is safe.
Excessive panting, they're going to be vomiting. They're going to be lethargic. They could end up having seizures. Seizures would be on the more extreme case.
Since temps will be in the 90s this week, especially tomorrow, that pavement can get as hot as 140 to 150 degrees. So a good tip, if you are going to take your pet out for a quick walk, have them walk in the grass so they don't burn their paws on the pavement. A dip in the water like that little guy will help them cool down as well. And remember, lots of water on days like today. And if you plan on letting your dog out, try to do it early in the morning or after the sun goes down to limit time during the hottest parts of the day.
Some really good tips that I will take advantage of for Bascom. Shane Hogan, thank you very much.
Meantime, climate scientists are warning that the extreme heat will continue if we keep burning fossil fuels. A new study from the journal Nature shows climate change could collapse the world's crucial system of ocean currents, affecting every person on the planet. Now, when this system breaks down, researchers say we'll see more extreme weather, including more extreme winters and rising sea levels. Researchers say the system could collapse as early as 2025 and no later than 2095. And their report calls for fast measures to cut planet heating pollution like the burning of fossil fuels to zero.
A 19-year-old Marine from Verona is dead after being found in a car in North Carolina. Lance Corporal Tanner Kaltenberg had been in active duty since 2021, serving at Camp Lejeune. Deputies found the bodies of his and two other Marines Sunday around 9 in the morning. They were in a car parked outside of a convenience store about an hour away from the military training facility. Authorities are still investigating the cause of their death.
Two teenagers in big trouble this morning, accused of leading Lodi police on a high-speed chase. This happened early yesterday morning at about 3:30. Police say an officer saw a car speeding on Water Street without its lights on. Speeds revved up to over 100 miles an hour. The car ended up crashing into a construction zone near the interstate, and that's when two people hopped out of the car and took off, though they left a 16-year-old girl behind. She was injured and had to be rushed to UW Hospital. Officers ended up arresting the 16 and 17-year-old that ran.
You might want to watch your speed today. 22 law enforcement agencies and the Wisconsin State Patrol will be out in Dane County. It's part of Speed Awareness Day. They'll be conducting increased traffic speed surveillance and reminding residents of the dangers of speeding. This year, there's been an increase in speeding and dangerous driving in Dane County. It's led to 5 deaths and 140 serious injuries.
Looking ahead, next week, 2 blocks along Atwood Avenue will close for construction. Crews are going to be putting in a new water main and sewers. The roads are going to be fully closed between Fair Oaks Avenue and Oak Ridge and Sugar Avenues. It starts Monday at 7 o'clock in the morning, so if you live near this site, here's what you can do. You can use Ludington, Welch, Center, or Garrison Avenues to get home. If you're looking to access the Olbrich Botanical Gardens or the Park Boat Launch, use Walter Street.
An update to a story we brought you back in 2020, the Monterey Hotel. It's been standing in Janesville for almost a century now. Well, now it's serving the community as an apartment complex. It's part of an effort to get much-needed housing to Janesville residents and boost the city's economy.
It brings more people into our downtown. Those people will be visiting our retail sites, our restaurant sites, and more, of course, to recruit additional people to come to Janesville to work.
The location was abandoned in the 90s after decades of being at the center of the city's social scene. Rates start at $800 a month. There are 51 units.
Democrats are introducing legislation to implement adult-sized changing stations in some public buildings. It's part of a state effort to make public buildings more accessible for people with disabilities. The bill was reintroduced after it was cut from the governor's budget plan. It includes a tax credit for small businesses that choose to participate. The bill's co-author, Representative Robin Vining, says the lack of universal changing stations limits where disabled Wisconsinites can go, saying this is a public health and human dignity issue.
606, the Joint Finance Committee is allowing Wisconsin to withdraw from a lawsuit. The suit was against the federal government over the Trump administration's reallocation of federal funds. Members of the committee voted unanimously to drop it. Wisconsin's National Guard was supposed to get $8 million for a training facility at Truex Airfield here in Madison. The Trump administration took that money away, putting it instead toward the border wall. Well, the Biden administration halted construction of the wall and announced the Guard will now receive $10.5 million. The increase is likely accounting for updated project designs.
Meantime, the Biden administration says it will appeal a ruling blocking its asylum policy. Tuesday, a federal judge ruled against that policy, which blocks most people from seeking asylum if they cross the border illegally. The ruling comes after a scathing report from Human Rights First early this month. That report detailed how many migrants trying to enter legally say they were threatened, tortured, and even raped in the process. The Biden administration says it remains confident that its position is lawful.
An update now. President Biden's son is expected back in court today. Hunter Biden is expected to formally agree on a deal on federal tax charges, avoiding prison time. Republicans in Congress might be trying to block the deal, though. They call it a sweetheart deal. This after two IRS whistleblowers say he got special treatment from the Justice Department. The Justice Department, however, denies those claims.
If you have Spotify, you might notice a price hike for your subscription. The streaming service's ad-free plan just added a buck for premium subscribers. That subscription going from $10 to $11 a month. Spotify's other plans also going up by a buck as well. The company says the increases will help it deliver value to both artists and fans. There is still a free user plan, though, which includes ads and limited features.
Memorial Union is launching a year-long celebration of its 175th anniversary tonight. You can head to the terrace between 4 and 10. From 4:30 till 6, a local band will be playing 80s new wave, and rock covers. Members of the U.S. Marching Band will take the stage after that. Then Wood Music is hosting its weekly open mic night. That runs until 9. You can also check out a new Bucky the Badger statue. That's going to be debuted, available for photos. Of course, Wisconsin-themed snacks will be on hand from Babcock Dairy and Varsity Meats. That'll be held in the Sunset Lounge. And fireworks will be on display to end the night. The event is free for everybody.
Sounds like a real party.
175 years.
Isn't that incredible? That's older than I am.
I didn't say it.
It's older than Kelly.
Hey. Yeah. Hey. 175 years. Happy birthday to the Memorial Union.
Yes. All right, coming up in sports, another former Badger headed to Illinois. How the Big Ten is shaping up ahead of the season.
And we are watching some potential for severe storms north of Madison this morning. We'll track those rain chances for you coming up. First warm weather just ahead.
Plus, we're in the 608 this morning talking concerts on the square and what you need to know as the 40th season comes to a close over the next week.
Dear Freedom, here's to more miles driven, more dollars saved, and more electrified vehicles than any other brand. Yours, Toyota Hybrids. Toyota, let's go places.
Ride a chip. Just taking a break. That window's a bear.
Don't worry. My cousin's got a guy.
Hey, I'm not sure I can help you with the house guest, but I can help you replace this window fast.
Let the experts at Feldco kickstart your summer with 2-for-1 windows and no interest until 2025. Plus, we'll get it done Feldco fast.
2-for-1 windows ends Monday. Hurry. Call now.
Call 866 for Feldco.
Summer fun means one thing. It's time to visibly say goodbye to crow's feet, fine lines, wrinkles, and under eye bags, and say hello to smooth, beautiful, younger looking skin in 10 minutes with Plexaderm.
Oh my God. I can't believe I have no lines in my face. I'm like 20 years younger.
Plexaderm smooths away wrinkles without foundation, without color makeup, and without expensive procedures. And it works in 10 minutes. Plus, the results last up to 10 hours. And best of all, you could try it for only $14.95 this summer.
This isn't the first time I've been on TV raving about this product. It's amazing. My friends, my family, they can't believe it. There's been creams, there's been lotions. Nothing works like this.
We were away on vacation. If you go down to the islands, they always want to take you in a booth and put some stuff on you. And my husband said, boy, that stuff really works. And I said, I washed this off hours ago. This is Plexaderm. This is what works.
When I tried Plexaderm the first time, my daughter said, oh, Dad, did you get a haircut? And I said, no, I tried this Plexaderm product out. Oh, you look so much younger. I said, oh, thank you.
The instant results are from naturally based silicates found in shell clay. Once applied, your skin tightens and firms, rapidly reducing under eye bags and wrinkles from view in minutes. The science is incredible, but the results are even better.
Yeah, this looks really good. All these lines are gone. Amazing. Oh, I shouldn't say that. I look amazing. I was like so full of myself.
I've had under eye bags for a very long time, and it sucks. Finally, I tried something called Plexaderm. I put it on my face, and I'm not joking. It works.
So take action this summer and pack up your under eye bags and wrinkles and put them on vacation with Plexaderm. Try our summertime special and get it for only $14.95. Plus, get free shipping. Visit PlexadermTrial.com or call the number on your screen.
Dear Freedom, here's to more miles driven, more dollars saved, and more electrified vehicles than any other brand. Yours, Toyota Hybrids. Toyota, let's go places.
You're watching News 3 Now this morning.
Okay, we only have a couple more chances to check out concerts on the square this season.
Josh Frider is in the 608 with what's on tap tonight. Hey, Josh.
Good morning, guys. News 3 Now, of course, a proud sponsor of Concerts on the Square. And as the concert celebrates 40 years of bringing free music to the community, we're highlighting the importance and positive impact it continues to bring to the city of Madison. Even though weather-related delays made for a rough start to this 40th season, it sure hasn't stopped the thousands of people flooding to downtown Madison to take in the tunes. Tonight is being called the Millennial Mixtape as Canadian-based Jeans and Classics returns for a playlist of popular songs from the 80s to 2000s, featuring songs by artists such as Adele, Bruno Mars, Sia, and Ed Sheeran. I caught up with Wisconsin Chamber Orchestra CEO Joe Lanis earlier this morning on the square. Joe says this 40th season has already been a memorable one, and he can't wait to see how much it continues to grow in the decades to come.
It's been a season to remember. We obviously bring such a big part of Madison to downtown with Concerts on the Square, and we've had a couple of false starts and rain delays, but at any rate, we've had huge crowds. People have been loving the concerts, and we're just so happy to do this every week.
So you can help continue to keep Concerts on the Square free for all to enjoy. We have that number on the screen right there. Text CONCERTS to 801-801. You can also go to their website. It's just $40 for 40 years. There's also a new line of merchandise available. You can find all of this up right now on channel3000.com. When you think about it, $40 for 40 years, that really is not that much money.
That's a deal.
And it's such a big deal for the community. I mean, you guys have been out there before. So many people come out for this. Let's keep it free and just keep this summer staple here in Madison.
For all they do for us, it's the least we could do for them. And after the rough season they've had, I mean, Joe did a good job of kind of like playing it down.
Oh, yeah,
we've had some late starts and cancellations and stuff. It's like they need this now. And it's up to us to
big
be
time.
There for them.
Yeah, in the last couple of weeks here, I think tonight's going to be awesome. Next week, they're going to be going out with a bang as well, looking over the years. So there's a lot to look forward to over the next couple of years. And I know we are super proud to be a sponsor of this.
Yes.
Chris, you're going to be out there tonight going live.
I'm up. It's my turn.
It's your turn.
So I'm putting together, so the theme tonight is millennial mixtape.
Yep.
So you're going to break out the dad jeans?
What do you mean? Just jeans?
I think it's called jeans and classics, right?
I just call them jeans.
Well, Stanford is classic in jeans. So there you go.
I was going to say, I'm writing up my millennial mixtape.
Nice.
What my millennial mixtape would be, and I'm going to see if they'll let me show that tonight.
Oh, my gosh.
Stay tuned.
I'll be watching.
Wow.
Thanks, Josh.
You bet.
Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. You can reach out to him on social media or shoot him an email for a chance to be featured.
All right, 616. Kelly Slifka's out on the patio. How far away is that rain, Kelly?
It's still a little ways away from the Madison area, but they have been getting hammered not too far, about 50 miles north of Madison. You've seen these storms just roll on through the Adels, roll through the Portage area, Baraboo, moving through Green Lake and Marquette counties, Northern Columbia County, headed over there toward Dodge County as well. A lot of lightning with these cells. Officially, the warning has just been canceled, or it actually just expired at 6:15. But look at all that red showing up and all those lightning strikes moving through Green Lake and Marquette counties, and even down toward Partyville, headed over there toward parts of Beaver Dam area, expecting that fairly shortly as well. As it's moving on to the east about 45 miles per hour, still can expect some winds to 50 miles per hour. That's the main threat, and obviously a lot of lightning. So if you are within the path of that, make sure you're indoors and try to stay away from those windows with the potential of some of those wind gusts up to 50 miles per hour. Our chance of rain here in Madison is off to the south and west. Right now, moving through parts of Grant County. This is likely to be producing some heavy downpours as well. Nothing severe, but is indicating some lightning there between Lancaster and Boscobel there, moving through Crawford and Grant County. 68 Madison, I tell you what, it is hot under the collar this morning. That's the dew point temperature, 68. 72 in Janesville, 72 in Platteville. When you're starting to talk about dew points getting close to 70, uncomfortable, and that's without even doing any kind of activity. So, yeah, you're feeling that humidity out there this morning, and we'll likely hold in the lower 70s throughout the morning hours, because with some of this rain moving in, that's going to leave a lot of leftover moisture, so the air is going to get very stagnant today. Morning storms should come to an end. Hazy afternoon sun. Tomorrow's actually going to be hotter. Temperatures in the mid-90s, and when you factor in that humidity, temperatures feeling like nearly 100. So once again, those dew points are up there in the upper 60s and low 70s. Actual temperature right now is 75 in Madison. They have had some rain cool there in the Adels, Camp Douglas, Wautoma, and Black River Falls area. So scattered showers and thunderstorms this morning. Everything lifting to the east and northeast as we go through about 10, 11 o'clock. Still clouds holding in toward the noon hour, but gradually thinning out. I think we'd be well in the 90s if the clouds didn't hold on as long as they will, but they will hold on a little bit. Still the upper 80s, low 90s, especially areas to the west and south. Now, Friday, most of the day dry, but as we get in the evening hours, this is a cold front that's going to sink in, bring us another chance for some rain, and this will break the heat going into the upcoming weekend. First warm forecast, morning showers and storms coming to an end. Just a steamy afternoon, 88, 95 tomorrow, 90 Friday. Most of that rain will hold off until the evening hours. Saturday and Sunday look quite a bit cooler with lower humidity and low 80s.
The Brewers had to be feeling pretty good about themselves heading into game two against the Reds. They have a 1.5 game lead on them in the standings, and Corbin Burns is on the bump. His last two outings, zero runs, 23 strikeouts, and two wins. Jump to the ninth, though, Brewers down 4-0, down to the last out. Christian Yelich gives them some life. His three-run bomb cuts the lead to one, but that's as close as they'd get. Brewers fall 4-3. There's no easy way to say this, so we're just going to rip off the Band-Aid. Jim Leonard is joining Brett Bielema's staff and will serve as a senior football analyst for the Illini football team. The former Wisconsin defensive coordinator becomes the fourth former Badger to team up with the Illini, joining Aaron Henry, Antonio Fanellis, and Bielema, who actually coached Leonard during his senior season at UW. The Badgers will travel to Illinois to face the Illini on October 21st. Speaking of Wisconsin football, for the fourth straight year, the Badgers are picked to win the Big Ten West. They edged out Iowa by one vote for the top spot. Minnesota, Illinois, and Nebraska round out the top five. Remember, UW hasn't won the West since 2019. Michigan is the favorite to not only win the East, but the Big Ten this season. And DeForest Anna Sapieniak capped off her senior season on the track in the best way possible. Two individual titles and a team championship. That performance at state helped her earn Wisconsin's Gatorade Girls Track and Field Athlete of the Year honors, and in turn, a $1,000 grant to give back to the next generation. Her choice was an easy decision. The Bolts Track Club, where her love for the sport began.
That's kind of just like where my love for the sport kind of took off, because it kind of just started off as just like a cool thing to do in the summer, but I knew that I really liked track and field, and I feel like Sun Prairie was where it really like took off. Knew I wanted it to go to track because that's kind of what I was recognized for, and this was just a perfect opportunity.
And that's it for Morning Sports. Have a great day.
Thanks, Zach. Coming up, how one Wisconsin student is using a unique skill to teach important lessons about water.
And as we head to break, a look at gas prices this morning here in Dane County and across the state. We'll be right back.
Watch News 3 Now at 6 with Eric, Charlotte, Gary, and Zach weeknights.
Get up to 56% off list at our huge 56th anniversary sale at Slumberland Furniture. Plus, enter to win a free car, living rooms, bedrooms, mattresses, and more. 56th anniversary sale at Slumberland Furniture.
Our phones keep us constantly connected.
Can you switch to airplane mode?
But what if they had a mode to help us actually connect? Introducing Us Mode, a mode that makes our phones less distracting, so we can focus on quality time. So the notifications we get are the ones that matter. So we're never distracted from what's most important. Visit U.S. Cellular in-store or online to set up Us Mode for free, even if you're not a customer. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Wherever you go, wherever you stay, all you need is one key. Earn and use rewards across Expedia, Hotels.com, and Vrbo.
We're reinventing our network
with smarter, more efficient routes,
so you can deliver more value to your customers.
Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
When you pull up to someone's house, the first thing you see nowadays is their garage door.
Let Precision's experienced designers come to your home and help you select the perfect door for your house.
Precision is there to help.
Precision Door Service, a name you can trust.
What do we always say, son? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance.
They only pay for what you need.
That's my boy.
Stay off the freeways.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
I'm here for
your annual eye exam.
Because I'm having trouble
reading.
Exactly.
They sort of make me feel
like I'm the most fabulous thing you've ever seen.
Exactly.
I'll take them.
Set summer in motion with the most electrifying Honda vehicles yet. Like the CR-V and the Accord. Both with available hybrid powertrains. Designed to deliver more thrilling performance and more innovative tech. Make every adventure more electrifying with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Incredible mattress deals. Plus, enter to win a free car at the huge 56th anniversary sale at Slumberland. Up to 56% off list. Amazing deals on mattresses, pillows, sheets, and more at Slumberland. It's a big deal.
Welcome back. We always ask you to share your morning with us. Gwen is giving us a peek of her gorgeous garden, this beautiful pink lily.
That is a great photo. So vibrant.
Indeed. Very summery.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing, Gwen. It's a gorgeous photo. You can do the same. Just use the hashtag MyNews3Morning when you post on social media so we can find it.
624, Shane Hogan here this morning with the trending story of the day.
Good morning, folks. I'll start you with the question. Have you ever met a professional mermaid?
Can't say I have.
Neither have I.
Well, here you go. I'm going to introduce you to one. This is Echo, a student at UW-Milwaukee, and they're working on a master's degree in freshwater sciences. In their spare time, they work as a professional mermaid. Yeah, you heard me right. Echo says that entails teaching children about inclusion, aquatic safety, and conservation through a special multi-day mermaid class that's certified by the Professional Association of Diving Instructors.
Bonus points for your graphic here.
Thank you.
Very
Thank
nice.
You. Very proud Call of this one. I needed to think about it for about 30 seconds, then I was like, got it.
Stamper, will you sing this for folks who might not?
Part of your world.
It's beautiful.
And we just lost half the viewers now. This is really cool, though. I mean, look, I mean, they really get the whole getup going, for sure. The tail, the wig or the hair looks great.
Big fan. A lot of learning happening there, that's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, fascinating. They're probably more likely to get my kids' attention than mine if I'm trying to teach them anything. Hey, let's check in with Kelly Slifka. He is tracking some showers headed into Dane County. Where is it at, Kelly?
Yeah, we did have some warnings earlier this morning. No warnings currently. We do have some intense storms up to the north, and especially the northeast of Madison, rolling through Columbia and also Dodge County. Well, the first warning forecast update coming up right after the break.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
We're busy. I get it. So Stanton Optical works with your schedule. Buy online, pick up in-store same day, and get a free fitting. I mean, look at my to-do list.
Skip the wait. Get your kids' glasses made the same day, only at Stanton Optical.
Attention, Wisconsin veterans.
I'm Tony Evers, the governor of Wisconsin. If you are a veteran struggling to pay for rent, utilities, or other life-sustaining services, I want you to know that the Veterans Rental Assistance Program is here to help. So call 833-WISVRAP or visit VRAPWI.com. You've always been there for us. We want you to know that we're here for you.
You never know what opportunities life will send your way. But if you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis or psoriatic arthritis, Enbrel can help you say, I'm in for what's next. Willing to put yourself out there to try something new?
I'm in.
Care for a seat at the Thursday night game?
I'm in.
Upgrading your home court?
I'm in.
Enbrel helps relieve joint pain and helps stop permanent joint damage. And with less pain, you're free to join in. Enbrel may lower your ability to fight infections, serious, sometimes fatal events, including infections, tuberculosis, lymphoma, other cancers, nervous system and blood disorders, and allergic reactions have occurred. Tell your doctor if you've been someplace where fungal infections are common, or if you're prone to infections, have cuts or sores, have hepatitis B, have been treated for heart failure, or if you have persistent fever, bruising, bleeding, or paleness. Don't start Enbrel if you have an infection like the flu. When opportunities come your way, be ready to say, I'm in for what's next. Ask your doctor about Enbrel.
At
Stanton Optical, you get great value on eye care, including contacts. Right now, get a one-year supply of AccuView Oasis and an eye exam for only $189. Scan now to book your eye exam. Yay, technology!
Right now, the nationwide heat wave making its way to Wisconsin. How to protect yourself and others.
Plus,
if everything they said is true, we're happy about it.
A proposed deal that could save the U.S. economy billions.
And let's give you your first look outside this morning. Kelly continues to track storms to the north and west that are lighting up the radar, Kelly.
Yeah, that's right. We've got two clusters of storms, one up to the north and another one to the west. It looks like the one to the north will stay north of Madison, but we'll track those storms coming in from the west coming up.
Hey, good Wednesday morning, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to News 3 Now this morning. I'm Chris Stanford.
And I'm Leah Lynchide. Happy Wednesday. Kelly's talking about a wet one, potentially here in Madison. You're tracking out the timing this morning.
Yeah, it looks like that big cluster that's held up to our north is going to stay to the north of the Madison area, but it has been producing a lot of lightning in parts of Columbia County. The Dells got hammered with some lightning, some gusty winds as well. And most of that now tracking over there toward Fond du Lac and Oshkosh. Does extend a little bit further to the south in parts of Columbia County. Now moving into Dodge County, the Columbus area, Beaver Dam. Expected some of this to be clipped, at least on the southern fringe of it. Heavier weather up there toward Fond du Lac and Oshkosh. But we're watching is off to the west now, moving through parts of southwestern Wisconsin, through Grant County, starting to move into parts of Iowa County fairly shortly here. Pretty good cluster here just to the east of Lancaster. That's moving on to the east about 45 miles per hour. Still a little ways off from Madison, but it should be tracking in over the next couple of hours, bringing us an opportunity for some rain. This will be mainly this morning. And then as we get into late morning hours, that should be tracking on to our east. Still cloudy weather for the noon hour, but I think gradually the sun should break out. And then it's going to get very steamy going into the afternoon with that humidity way up there today after this rain. Already very humid. Right now, 75. The dew points are flirting with 70, so you can definitely feel that humidity today. 75 right now. The winds are out of the south. Those scattered showers and thunderstorms this morning coming to an end by the noon hour with some sunshine by the early afternoon hours. Those temperatures will soar. Even gets hotter tomorrow and another round of storms later this week. More coming up.
All right, Kelly Slifka, thank you very much. This extreme heat impacting everyone in our area, even the folks who are used to dealing with fires.
Our Shane Hogan is here to explain that firefighters have an awful tough job when it gets this hot, Shane.
Yeah, that's right, Chris. If you add in that current heat wave we're dealing with right now, the act of fighting fires can make for a serious risk of heat stroke. Fire departments in southern Wisconsin are taking steps to prevent their crews from succumbing to these conditions. One measure that Madison's fire department is doing is to provide Gatorade and water to its firefighters to keep them safe and healthy. The assistant chief says its staff also taking frequent breaks to avoid adverse health risks.
We'll pull a crew out when it's hot. They'll expend their bottle and then they'll come out and do rehab where they typically in this heat will find a shady place. They'll strip some of their turnout gear off. Put new bottles on and ready to go back in, and some of that will be the intake of fluids to make sure that they stay cool.
In Rock County, the Janesville Fire Department is doing the same for its new recruitment training, saying they're making modifications of what they usually would do, like adding extra breaks and a cooling tent with fluids. Now, remember, firefighters are usually carrying between 50 to 70 pounds of gear when fighting fires, so conditions are tough any time of year, but especially during the peak of summer like we're in right now. So I think we can all agree we are very thankful for all the hard work that they are doing.
You said it, Shane. I can't imagine doing that job, let alone carrying that much gear and
just very intense
smothering. All right, thanks, Shane. And with the hot weather this week, Public Health Madison Dane County reminding you to stay cool and hydrated. If you spend a lot of time outside, you could get heat stroke or heat exhaustion. If you do have to be outside, don't forget a water bottle or a jug and make sure you're drinking out of it a lot. Staying hydrated is key, of course. It may sound obvious, but reminders like these can help save lives.
You know, some of this advice we're giving is common sense things, you know, like if you're hot, cool yourself down, you know, like drink water if you're feeling dehydrated. It's not revolutionary ideas, but they're important.
And this is really important here. The best ways to treat heat stroke and heat exhaustion is to gradually cool that person down. You don't want to give them fluids right away. Instead, you want to sponge them down with cool water. And once they start drinking water, once they start cooling down, start with that water slowly. Slow sips are more helpful than big gulps.
To stay ahead of the heat, find cooling centers in your area and be on top of the potential storms this week. Download the First Warn Weather app. Just search for WISC Weather in your app store. To our other top stories this morning, a 64-year-old Madison father accused of killing his 25-year-old son apparently did so over an argument about 25 cents. That's according to Dane County court documents. John Shively is charged with first-degree intentional homicide in the shooting death of his son, Zachary. A criminal complaint alleges John gave Zachary $2, and Zachary got upset, insisting he needed 25 more cents. He told investigators his son then hit him and pushed him into a corner. That's when he grabbed a gun and shot Zachary.
Developing this morning, an 18-year-old's now in police custody for shooting another 18-year-old. Madison police say it happened Sunday evening on Coho Street in Madison and believe it was targeted. The suspect faces a potential charge of attempted homicide. He's in jail this morning awaiting his first court appearance today. New this morning, major expenses like homes and vehicles could be getting more expensive. That's because the Federal Reserve is expected to announce another interest rate hike this afternoon. Inflation's cooled to 3% from its record high of 9% last winter, but some experts hope another rate hike will lower inflation even more. Other analysts, though, believe this could cut off the nation economically and create a threat to the U.S. economy. If a rate hike is announced this afternoon, it would be the 12th this year, setting interest rates at the highest they've been in 22 years.
Let's take a live look now at Atlanta, Georgia, where staff at the UPS headquarters and around the country are breathing a momentary sigh of relief. With just 6 days until a strike, Teamsters and the UPS agreeing on a tentative deal for a new contract. The agreement still needs to be ratified by union members, and that could take weeks. And a no vote could still trigger a strike, but that wouldn't happen now until late August. Union reps say the UPS is putting up $30 billion in new money, in part for full and part-time wages.
This is good. This is a start. I mean, the language is there, but if everything they said is true, we're happy about it.
UPS's CEO characterized the deal as a, quote, win-win-win agreement. The full details of that agreement aren't public yet. Okay, check this out. A new and rather unique flavor is joining the Skittles rainbow, the popular candy partnering with French's to make a mustard-flavored candy. It's for National Mustard Day on August 5th. It's only going to be available at French's Mustard Mobile in select cities, but good news for Wisconsinites, you can enter a sweepstakes for a chance to win the package.
I was worried that we wouldn't have a chance to get it.
Thank goodness.
I don't understand. Like, I know why they do this, but I'm just, every time I'm like, come on. Like, they do this so we can put their name out there, right?
And we do it.
And we do it.
Here we are.
We fall for it every time.
I would try. I like mustard.
Yeah, I'd try it.
I'd give it a shot.
I like mustard.
I like mustard.
I like mustard.
Mustard. Love lamp.
6:37 coming up on our Health Watch. A new study that can help parents tell if their children will develop allergies.
And we are tracking showers and thunderstorms rolling through southern Wisconsin. We'll have the first morning forecast coming up.
Plus, we're in the 608 this morning talking concerts on the square and what you need to know as the 40th season comes to a close. You're watching News 3 Now.
Fresh produce is the best produce. That's why at Pick and Save, we invest in Wisconsin farmers to bring you the freshest seasonal picks. So no matter how you shop, your local produce always tastes as fresh as it gets. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
Precision is very proud of our 5-star reviews. I do everything I can to go above and beyond for repairs. No, I'm not an actor. I'm a garage door tech. That's what I do here at Precision.
Precision Door Service, a name you can trust.
Lean back and enjoy the summer savings at the Century House. Right now, get a $100 instant rebate for every $1,000 you spend on any qualifying stressless seating. The more you spend, the more you can save instantly. So furnish an entire room with the most comfortable seating in the world and watch the savings add up. Shop the Century House, 3420 University Avenue in Madison.
Wish you had help getting things done.
Same.
So I got Spectrum One.
Fast internet, unlimited mobile, and advanced Wi-Fi, all for a great price. Want it? Here's the number.
Call 833-784-4999 to get Spectrum internet for $49.99 a month, plus advanced Wi-Fi and your first line of unlimited mobile free for 12 months. Spectrum internet delivers the fastest download speeds in the nation.
Which helps me run all of this easily.
Kids checkups? Scheduled. Work?
Lost. Treat dispenser? Treating. And since I'm always on this, unlimited mobile is a no-brainer. Work.
Switch to Spectrum One. 300 megabit internet, unlimited mobile, and advanced Wi-Fi for enhanced security.
Spectrum One. Gets it done.
Get Spectrum Internet for $49.99 a month, plus advanced Wi-Fi, and your first line of unlimited mobile free for 12 months. Call 833-784-4999, visit Spectrum.com, or stop by a store today.
Jump back into school with Macy's specials, like 40% off kids' jeans, plus juniors' tees $12.99 and up, and up to 50% off kids' looks, too. Own your style at Macy's.
At Pick and Save, everyone wins when it comes to savings because you get the same great prices, deals, and rewards on pickup or delivery as you do in store. So no matter how you shop, everyone saves big. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
On the next Live at 4, a Concerts on the Square preview.
And we go behind the wheel with Harvey Briggs in the 2023 Mercedes-Benz GLC 300, a compact SUV that's all about comfort and luxury at a fair price.
A season of drought leading to raging wildfires that just can't seem to end.
A large fire in July like that is unusual.
News 3 Now takes you beyond the barometer for a deep dive into the longer than normal fire season and its impact here, Thursday at 6. You're watching News 3 Now this morning.
Welcome back. From eczema to hay fever, kids with allergic conditions might be on track to develop others down the road.
Researchers looked at the electronic medical records of nearly 220,000 children who were screened, and the results showed a trend that's referred to as the allergic march, a natural progression of allergic reactions. So over the course of this study, this allergic march shows these diseases from infancy through childhood. Eczema is the first in line, with its telltale rashes and dry patches popping up in over 10% of the children studied, usually around 4 months of age. Then, around 13 months old, the study found peak onset of food allergies and asthma in young kids. At a little over 2 years old, researchers found high rates of hay fever. According to the CDC, more than one in four children have eczema or an allergy.
Just about 6:42 on your Wednesday. Kelly Slifka is outside with your forewarn weather, tracking some active radar. Good morning, Kelly.
Yeah, good morning. We did have quite a few thunderstorms just roll through the north of Madison this morning. Still ongoing, but we are watching more storms off to the west. So we've got two clusters right now, one northeast of Madison moving into parts of Dodge County. You notice all the lightning with some of these cells as it's moving closer to Beaver Dam and looking at 151 up toward Fond du Lac, seeing some pretty intense cells. Also to the west, the southwest, we're looking at some showers and storms rolling out of Grant County, now moving into Iowa County. So some of these storms have some lightning. None of this is severe, but we can expect some heavy downpours and wouldn't doubt if we don't see some gusty winds. As we look forward, as we track these out, it looks like it'll be in the Dodgeville area here in about 5 minutes or so. And if it continues on its track, looking at Barneville just after 7 o'clock this morning. That looks like our opportunity of rain here in the Madison area. So it'll be kind of a quick one-and-done thing this morning. And then we'll just get back into some heat this afternoon. You can kind of see that haze out there. That's not the smoke. That's the humidity today. We got that humidity up there and expecting that high up to 88. We'd be a lot hotter if we didn't get this morning rain. And some of these clouds are going to linger into the early afternoon hours. But it's going to feel very hot regardless. The heat index today in the mid, maybe the upper 90s going this afternoon. Maybe hear that wind blowing behind me. Also, we had a wind gust here in the backyard, but it's going to be a scorching hot day. So if you are working outdoors, make sure you take frequent breaks, drink plenty of fluids. Tomorrow's heat index, some locations getting very close to 100 going into the afternoon. So we are looking at some extreme heat going forward into our Thursday. And now take a look at our temperatures. We're going to be flirting with 90 degrees. This is a reminder, do not leave anything in the car, your pets, your kids, for any duration of time. In about 10 minutes, you can see that temperature rise up to about 110 degrees already. 20 minutes, almost up to 120. Very dangerous to leave anything for any duration inside a vehicle. Scattered boarding storms coming to an end. Otherwise, it's just going to be hazy, hot, and humid this afternoon. Tomorrow is going to be the hottest day with that heat index flirting with 100. Right now it's muggy 74. They did have some rain cool there up there in the Dells. They kind of got rocked this morning. Hopefully some of those campers got away from the campers because some of those winds were up there overnight. 74 right now in Madison, 73 in Wanakee, 73 in Sun Prairie. As the wind gusts are starting to pick up here this morning, showers and storms rolling on through. By the noon hour, all this should be on to our east. Looking at some clouds lingering into the early afternoon hours, and then I think we'll get into some hazy sunshine as temperatures climb into the upper 80s. First warm forecast keeps it hot tomorrow up to 95, heat index near 100. A good chance for some showers and storms. That'll be coming in late Friday evening. That's going to be the heat breaker. That's going to be the cold front that'll drop the humidity and temperatures for Saturday and Sunday a little bit more seasonable into early next week.
Okay, Kelly Slifka, thank you very much. We appreciate it. Just about 6:45, there are only a couple more chances to check out Concerts on the Square this season.
Josh Brider's here in the 608 this morning to tell us what's on tap for tonight. Hey there, Josh.
Hey, guys, good morning. News Free Now is a proud sponsor of Concerts on the Square, and as Concerts celebrates 40 years of bringing free music to the community, we're highlighting the importance and positive impact it continues to bring to the city of Madison. Tonight is being called the Millennial Mixtape as Canadian-based Jeans and Classics returns for a playlist of popular songs from the 80s to 2000s. They'll be featuring songs by artists such as Adele, Bruno Mars, Sia, and Ed Sheeran, so it should really be a fun one for the whole family. And of course, even though weather-related delays made for a rough start to this 40th season, Wisconsin Chamber Orchestra CEO Joe Lanis is still impressed by the community's support. I caught up with him earlier this morning on the Square. Here's his message of why your donations are so important as we look ahead to even more years for Concerts on the Square.
Text CONCERTS to 801-801 or go to our website, and it's $40 for 40 years. So for 40 years, we've had 6 million people come to downtown. We hope that we can raise some money this year so we can continue to do it for the next 40 years. We also have a new line of merchandise. If you want to celebrate your favorite summer tradition, check out our merch shop right outside Park Bank here, and you can get your favorite shirt or hat to bring the love of summer in Madison.
And here's that number one more time right there at the bottom of your screen. You can text CONCERTS to 801-801 or go to their website. It's super easy. Remember, $40 for 40 years. That's all it takes. And all of this can be found right now with a link on channel3000.com. Down to the last two Wednesdays here, guys. Hopefully, I mean, the weather, I'm glad the storms are rolling through this morning.
Yeah.
Tonight looks good, and hopefully next Wednesday can be good too, because we know how this year started for them, and we want to make sure they finish strong.
And a reminder, these concerts cost $1 million every summer to put on. Yeah. So 40 bucks, I mean, to keep this going for another 40 years, totally worth it.
And I'm always amazed at just the turnout, right? Like even last week when I was there and we were dealing with the storms and they had to delay it, or that was 2 weeks ago now, I can't even keep track of time. But even people that were coming out after the storm in waves, I mean, it was these people where it's like nothing can keep Madisonians away from concerts on
special.
The Square.
It's yeah, that special. It's the least we could do, giving back to for all they've done for us. Go ahead and donate. Thank you, Josh.
You bet.
Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. You can reach out to him on social media or shoot him an email for a chance to be featured. Okay, it is 6:47 on your Wednesday. Coming up in the morning sprint, it's also National Speed Awareness Day, where you're going to want to slow down to avoid police in the Dane County area.
We want to say happy birthday to Wyatt and all the kids turning 3 today. Happy birthday. Thanks for celebrating with us. We're back after this.
Sponsored by Three Bears Resort, Indoor Water Park and Conference Center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
It's your last chance to get Black Friday mattress deals at Ashley. Get the all-new Tempur-Breeze for just $83 a month. Or get this queen pillow top mattress for just $9 a month, all with no money down. Don't miss. Only at Ashley.
Sometimes it takes a different approach to see the possibilities all around you.
Thank you for coming together.
With Capella University's game-changing FlexPath format, take courses on your own terms and apply the skills you learn right away. Imagine your future differently with Capella University.
With Nurtec ODT, I can treat a migraine when it strikes and prevent migraine attacks all in one.
Don't take if allergic to Nurtec. Allergic reactions can occur even days after using. Most common side effects were nausea, indigestion, and stomach pain.
Ask about Nurtec ODT.
We're reinventing our network.
with smarter, more efficient routes, so you can deliver more value to your customers.
Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
We need to talk about Sona Bello.
We are getting rid of all of this. All of this today.
Ladies, this summer you can cover up or feel confident from head to toe with Sono Bello. One visit, permanent fat removal.
Look at this shape. My tummy is gone and my hourglass shape is back.
Wherever there's excess fat, we can remove it. That's what we do all day, every day.
Sono Bello's board-certified surgeons use micro-laser technology to safely target and remove your diet-resistant fat cells for good.
I could actually wear a two-piece after 25 years.
I have one big regret. I didn't go sooner.
Now, with our Best Body Summer event, you can schedule your free, no-obligation consultation, plus save $250 off instantly. That's $250 off your stomach, hips and thighs, back, and so much more. Call 1-888-634-9939 or go to sonobello.com.
What do we always say, son? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance.
They only pay for what you need.
That's my boy.
Stay off the freeways.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Don't wait until the weekend to enjoy a thick Charbroil steak made to your liking. Make a weeknight steak night at High Point Steakhouse, Southern Wisconsin's premier supper club. Well worth the short drive to Ridgeway.
It's your last chance to get Black Friday deals at Ashley. Find in-stock doorbusters at discounts up to 60% off. Plus, get bonus discounts on clearance items and special buys. And low monthly payment options starting at just $9 a month. Only at Ashley.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
6:51, time for the morning sprint.
With soaring temperatures today and tomorrow, cooling centers around southern Wisconsin are opening, giving people shelter from the heat. Here's a look at some of the centers in Middleton, Sun Prairie, and Beloit. More are available. Find the closest centers to you by checking out this story on channel3000.com.
A new study out this morning shows that the climate change, global warming, is having an alarming impact. Researchers say warming temperatures could cause ocean current systems to collapse. Those systems help regulate global temps, bringing warm water from the tropics to cool in the north. Scientists now say it's not a matter of if it'll collapse, but when.
The Federal Reserve is expected to raise interest rates again. We'll know by 1 this afternoon if that will happen. Most economists think the Fed will raise rates, even though inflation is cooling significantly. The bank held rates steady at its last meeting, which makes a hike all the more likely this month. If it does happen, this will be the 12th hike since last spring. The Rock County Public Health Department is warning residents about blue-green algae this morning. Officials say it was spotted in the Rock River and Lake Koshkonong. Health officials say anyone making plans to be in or on the water should be careful. Not just in Rock County, it has popped up several times this summer here in Dane. Avoid swimming near water that has a floating layer of scum. Make sure you, your pets, and young children don't swallow pond water. And rinse off after you go swimming.
Watch your speed today. It is Speed Awareness Day, so you know what that means. Officers, deputies, troopers are all going to be out to enforce speed limits and educate people about the dangers of speeding. Here in Dane County, nearly 24 local law enforcement agencies will be taking part in the initiative.
New court documents say a 65-year-old Madison father is accused of killing his 25-year-old son in an argument over 25 cents. John Shively is charged with first-degree intentional homicide. A criminal complaint alleges John gave his son, Zachary, $2. Zachary got upset, insisting he needed 25 more cents. Zachary shoved John responding by grabbing a gun and shooting him.
A tentative deal on a new contract could avoid a UPS worker strike. UPS putting up $30 billion in new money, which includes raises for full and part-time workers. The deal still needs to be ratified by the Teamsters Union. That could take several weeks. If members ended up rejecting the deal, a possible strike would now happen later next month.
Former Wisconsin Badgers defensive coordinator and interim head coach Jim Leonard has a new job for the upcoming football season. The Illinois football program announcing Leonard will be joining Brett Bielema's coaching staff as a senior football analyst. Brett Bielema, of course, also a former Wisconsin head coach. He has helped turn around the program at Illinois since taking the lead in 2021.
NBA star LeBron James' son, Bronny, in the hospital after suffering cardiac arrest during basketball practice. A spokesperson for the family says the 18-year-old is now out of the intensive care unit and his condition is stable. Bronny's heart suddenly stopped beating Monday at the University of Southern California. He is an incoming freshman for the USC basketball team.
One of the oldest 4-H fairs in the country is underway. The fair is full of attractions of all kinds. But by far the biggest attraction at the Rock County Fair is the junior exhibitors and their livestock. The biggest challenge this week, keeping their animals cool, which they do by giving them lots of water and then hosing them down regularly.
The Education Department opening a civil rights inquiry into Harvard's legacy admissions. Lawyers for civil rights filed a lawsuit alleging legacy applicants or relatives or alumni of alumni receive preferential treatment and are overwhelmingly white. The question now is whether Harvard's policy violates Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964.
Prosecutors are learning new information that might provide an alibi for Brian Koberger, the man accused of stabbing 4 students to death on an Idaho campus. The defense says Koberger was not at the place where the murders took place last November, but they haven't released any evidence or details about where else he might have been. He is facing 4 counts of attempted murder.
The Suffolk County District Attorney says officials are done searching the house of the suspect in at least 3 of the Gilgo Beach murders. The DA has said he can't say whether one of the women was killed in the house. He did say the suspect, Rhett Howerman, had almost 92 gun permits and quite a few long guns.
President Biden says insurance carriers need to do more to provide mental health coverage. Federal law already requires companies to provide equal access to medical and mental health benefits. Biden now announcing new rules that would require insurers to study whether their plans are following the law and make changes if necessary. The rules won't take effect for at least 60 days.
Well, good morning. It's been a stormy morning, especially areas to the north. Now it's moving to the north and east into parts of Dodge County. Looking at some heavy storms that have been moving through Fond du Lac, but also in the Beaver Dam area, seeing some pretty good storms as well. None of this is severe, but still could get some pretty good wind gusts coming in out of these storms. They rolled through the Adels overnight. Also watching to the south and west over there toward Dodgeville, a dying thunderstorm moving in. If this holds together, it looks like it'll be hitting the Madison area just after 7:30, it looks like, this morning. That'll be our opportunity of seeing some of that rain. It'll be mainly this morning with some showers and storms rolling on through. A break during the early afternoon hours and a little bit of a sunshine expected during the afternoon. Can't rule out an isolated storm, but I think most of this coming through this morning. Upper 80s today. It's going to feel like low to mid-90s, factoring in that humidity. And the first morning forecast brings in the heat again tomorrow.
Thank you, Kelly. Thanks for joining us, folks.